This is the Awesome Life Podcast.
I'm awesome. Team Awesome.
You think this is a game?
You think it's a game? Do you think it's a game?
Nah.
Could be a game. When's the last time we did this?
Probably May of last year.
The fuck is wrong with us?
It's been the
last time we did this was a year ago, right?
Yeah, about a year
ago. How many times since then have we said we're going to do this?
Really? Like, I can't even tell you.
Really?
How many
really amount of times? Really times? Like, really lots of times.
Like, really, really.
Like, 30 to 30.
So, welcome to the Awesome Life Podcast.
Welcome.
We're back. We have a special guest today. His name is White Jared.
I thought it was DJ.
Oh, yeah. DJ Colorado.
Come on, we talked about
DJ Colorado.
It's DJ Colorado.
Colorado.
It's a very good friend of mine that I met in CO.
Colorado.
In the CO.
What do they call you?
Mr. Phoenix. I had to think about that. It's been that long.
Yeah. I'm Lynx. Yeah, bro. This has been... It's been a grip. This feels kind of weird right now.
We gotta, like, shake off the rust.
We got that ring rust going on.
Yeah,
right
we
now.
Don't
this
have...
Weird.
We don't have the swag that we once had.
No, we don't.
This is terrible.
This is a terrible intro.
Is
bad. This is bad. This is not good. It's our first one back in a year. It's probably going to be our last.
They're going to take us off the airways. We're going to break the internet with this one.
Worst podcast of all time. This is not good.
So let's remind these motherfuckers who we are.
But you know what, though? This is bad, but we got a lot to talk about.
Yeah.
A lot has changed in a year.
Yeah. I look Muslim.
Yeah.
I look Muslim now. I have a full on beard.
Yeah. I came out of the closet.
This is news to me, everyone.
I like to keep them guessing. That's what happened to you in a year? You look Muslim?
Yeah, that's pretty much it. I went and became a gypsy in Colorado. I travel. I have a pet name.
You know, gypsies and Muslims aren't the same thing. You know this, right?
I know that. So, anyways, I'm going to give y'all a rundown. I moved to Colorado last June to explore new business opportunities. Can't get too far in detail, but...
It's pretty obvious.
The Fed's watching.
Yeah.
But, anyways... I took a little hiatus from the music.
A hiatus.
You see, this is... What is this? The Phoenix Roast Hour?
It's always the Phoenix Roast Hour, son.
You're giving us all this ammo.
I know.
That's all it does.
We'll get back to the story about me, you know, moving or whatever. But today has been, like, a terrible day. It's been actually excellent. But, in the story, I'm doing exactly what I was going to talk about in the story. My brain has literally been shutting down. I've been trying to get points across, and I'll just stutter and forget what I was going
to
say.
He was trying to tell me his hotel was on 42nd Street. It's like it's on 30. 30 or 30. 30.
They couldn't make a U-turn.
Oh my God! It was a vortex of no U-turns and no left.
So on South Beach, once you get past 30th Street, once you get past 42nd Street, when you're on I think Collins or whatnot.
You should clarify. We're in a hotel. Coming live from a hotel.
Yeah,
we are
reporting live.
South Beach.
Yeah.
What just happened?
I don't know. You said South Beach, and then you just forgot. South Beach and where the fuck am I?
I don't know if I like looking at a mirror while doing a podcast.
I don't like that either.
I feel like I'm trying to look at
some.
Yeah, I feel like I'm being watched.
That is kind of weird.
But I don't know. It gets us ready for the camera.
I guess.
Back to you, Bob.
I need to get on a diet before I'm ready for the cameras.
We've gained some weight since the last time we talked. Actually, no, I lost weight since the last time. I was like pushing like 500 last time I was on.
I don't know about all that.
It's pushing like 220. Now I'm pushing like 218.5 after this trip.
I've lost weight since
I got here. I was 200 pounds. I guarantee you when I fly back tomorrow, I get on a scale, I'm 212. Guaranteed.
You still got one more night, so there's a good chance of that. You got one more night, you got one more breakfast.
All day tomorrow, too.
Yep.
I started so good. I literally, on the way here, I had beef and vegetables at like 10:30 in the morning and didn't eat for the rest of the day. And then went out when I got to Miami at 10:30 at night. Started drinking, didn't eat nothing, and then I went home. And I puked my brains out the next morning.
There's been some puking.
When was that?
When I first got here, before I went to the Keys.
Oh, really?
When Stephanie picked me up.
Oh, you told me about
that. Oh, yeah, the very first night. There has been some puking.
So I've been getting a little sidetracked, but yeah. Colorado.
That's what we do.
I went to, broaden my horizons. It's dope out there, man.
I was gonna say, yeah.
It's dope.
I'm sure.
I love it. The quality of life's better.
I bet.
People
are probably 1,000 times nicer.
Yeah, but the women suck.
That's unfortunate.
Now I've witnessed this.
Is a Coloradan, and he didn't know what the potential South Florida
had going on down here.
You know, when I went out in Colorado, I was like, there's like no good-looking women.
You probably thought when you moved there, you're probably like, "Yo, it's just gonna be bad white bitches."
I thought it was gonna be Orlando. I thought it was gonna be just a bunch of wooties.
Just wooties everywhere.
Wooties everywhere. If you don't know what a wootie is,
I don't.
You're listening to the wrong podcast.
It's a white girl booty.
Oh, what wootie?
Yeah, white girl booty. Yeah, and then like you'll get a lot of girls that are real pretty, and then they got no bodies. There's no curvature.
No shape.
Yeah, no
that's
shit.
Worse. That's worse than, I don't know what I was going to say, but that's bad.
All the good women in Colorado like that, no are shape. Married to
yep. military that, I've men. Heard that. If they're hot, they're a trophy wife.
Yep, for a military guy.
For some military dude.
Yep.
Damn, that sounds shitty. Even if you go to like Denver, when you go downtown?
Nah, popping, Denver's better.
Denver's got some, better, some
we
stuff?
Don't, we don't do that, really. We need to.
Yeah, it's an hour.
Yeah, an hour away, you may as well.
And it's not even like it's not even an hour because of traffic. No, it's an hour because distance. The distance is that far.
So it's with a traffic, it's more.
Well, no, I'm not. There's no traffic. It's
oh, just, there ain't no traffic.
Well, you're driving. To get to downtown, yeah.
Yeah.
Actually in Denver.
Yeah.
Not on the driveway.
The highway? Nah.
Open highway.
Open highway. Deer is on the road.
Oh, I bet.
Mountains and all kinds of wildlife.
Nice.
I love the mountains.
I bet.
It's dope.
I can't wait to check this
out. I look at the mountains every morning and I'm like, you know what? I should write some shit. And then I don't.
And then you don't. Slacking ass.
You gonna hike it with me? 14er?
I'm not hiking to... I'm not going to Pikes Peak.
At least you did the incline.
That shit's 14,000 feet in the air.
Shit.
Fucking Colorado Springs, just off rip. Yes, off rip means like
just
from,
off rip.
You don't need to explain everything.
Okay. My friend over here is like culturally... stifled by the urban community.
He's Colorado born and raised, I guess, I assume.
Well, pretty much.
Just about. So yeah. And South Florida, that's different. That's a different world. Some slang. Some slang.
He asked me what a grip was the other day.
I just guessed that.
Oh, you guessed it?
Yeah.
I literally said
when I said it earlier.
About that?
Yeah.
When I said it earlier, we were making fun of him. I was like, "What's a grip?" I just said that as a joke.
No, I literally said...
no, I didn't ask that.
That's one of my favorites.
Because I heard that first when he said it today. And I didn't know what it was, and then he kind of explained it, so then I knew what it was after that.
So you just learned it today. That's even better. What was the other one?
I don't know.
Hook and chorus.
Yeah.
We got the difference between that. That was good.
What's a hook?
What's a...
No, that's, I knew
why
what
do they
hook
call
was,
it the hook?
Like, why is it called a hook?
Why is it called a hook?
Comes out a little bit. So I told him earlier, I was like, I'm just waiting for him to say Jeepers. Golly G Wilkers.
Holy alphabet soup, Batman.
I don't talk like how Greg was talking in the car earlier.
You see? Huh?
No way, sir.
Did that a little too well, buddy. A little too well.
So, what you been doing, Lynx?
I just been fucking making music.
Yeah.
Pretty much, yeah.
Tell us some exciting things.
I've been having, quite honestly, since you left, it's been the best time of my life, really.
Good. It's been the best time of my life since I left your ass.
I feel like I got this 212-pound weight off my back.
Oh, yeah. I was just weighing you down, right?
That's it, yeah. Nah, man, I've just been doing my thing, just making music. Working on an album.
Okay, what's it called?
September. And it's going to come out
September?
It's going to come out like June or July. I know that sounds dumb.
Yo, hold on. This time out. It's called September?
It's called September.
Because of your birthday?
So mine is
Oh, yeah? What day?
30.
Oh, mine's the 17th. No, it's like... How do I explain it? It's kind of a personal... It's not like my birthday, but the whole album is like... I don't like good things tend to happen to me in the month of September for some reason.
It's a great month.
Yeah, not just my birthday. And it's also kind of tied to like a past relationship that began in September. And the whole album is like... The whole album is the... Oh, it's not good towards the end of the album. But the whole album is like... It's a concept from the beginning of a relationship to the end of a relationship. So there's the like... Girl, what your name is. There's that part. Then there's like... when it's all good, it's Gucci. There's like when you're just destroying the pussy. There's that part of the relationship. There's the part where you hate this bitch and you tell your friend about it. That's the song we're doing together.
Yeah. And we'll chime back in on Fresh Out in a second.
Oh, it's coming.
But what about the part where you bury her?
No, it's not an Eminem album. It's not the Marshall Mathers LP3 over this bitch. Yeah, and then there's the part where you hate her guts, and then there's the part where you get sad, and then there's the part where you get over it. Yeah. Basically, that's the whole thing. I think it's gonna be cool. I think it's gonna be relatable, and it's fun. I've had like the time of my life making it. I just like it's good. I think it's my best work yet.
So, you and I are doing a track, and it's called
Fresh Out.
Fresh Out, yep. And why is it called Fresh Out?
Because it's that feeling that we all know when your lady is giving you shit and you're just fresh out of fucks. You got no, you can't give a fuck. You checked your front pockets, you checked your back pockets, you opened up the fanny pack, and you ain't got no fucks. You open all the drawers, and all you got is socks. You got no fucks.
No fucks to give.
You got no fucks to
give. And I'm at a point right now, I'm fresh out of fucks.
He and I are literally in the best position to make this song because we're both still pretty...
We're recovering alcoholics.
we're both a few months removed from just getting our hearts ripped out.
Pretty much.
Basically.
Corey, you can relate to what we're going through.
Not far off either, no.
You can intro the song.
Well, guys, I am totally fresh out of fucks today.
I am fresh out of fucks.
DJ Colorado.
Oh, man. Colorado.
I was saying, like, he could be, like, Riri. DJ Riri.
It was DJ Riri.
I'm just saying he could just be DJ Riri.
Just Riri.
Like, or my nigga Riri. Oh, I was saying, listen to this. I was like, yo, from now on, I'm going to call you my nigga Ree. And I wanted to like, write it out. Like, like MANIGUREE.
I like
nigga
it.
Ree.
It wouldn't be R-E-Y?
No. But it's going to be written out like that. It's okay. Really R-E-Y, but it's going to be my nigga Ree.
Manigari.
That just sounds like a word.
It sounds like a disease that you can catch.
Manigari.
Yo, I caught manigari last week.
I like it.
So you're big in the music, man. When are you gonna dive in?
Let me use your program.
He wants me to put Pro Tools on my laptop.
What do you want to do?
I think I want to let him.
Just mess with it. I don't have no idea.
Yeah, I mean it is fun regardless.
Thinking about it.
But
what the?
What the? Damn. I thought this was going to be way easier.
What, coming just back in the game?
Yeah, just hopping back in.
You thought we were just going to hop in? Like,
that, bro, that first 3 minutes is balls.
It's really bad.
Once you got going, it was fine.
Yeah.
I think we're... But see, now that we talked about it, it's going to get worse again.
There's going to be moments of silence.
It's going to be exactly dead air. Fucking dead air.
So let me ask you something, Corey. Can I call you Corey?
Maybe just talk about a whole bunch of other names you can call me.
Sea Sting?
Bro, he gives everybody a bunch of names.
Sea Stings.
That's just how it works.
Sea Stings.
Sea Stings.
That's just how it works.
Corey David. I'm giving his whole government name. His social is okay. 598-61.
Started off not that wrong.
Not that wrong. I've never
not that wrong.
I'm not that wrong.
Not right, but you're not that wrong.
Okay, what's the question?
So this is your first time in Florida. What do you think?
Not the first time in Florida.
Okay, so this is your first time in Florida, not with your...
South Florida, but...
This is the first time...
What part of Florida did you go to before?
Orlando a few times, Disney World and all that.
Okay, this is his first time
this
in...
This is different.
It is, yeah.
This is his first time in Florida without his rents. So...
Without his what? Yeah. His rents?
Yes.
What the... That's some slang I can't get into. Out the rents. I was like, wait, what does that mean? The first time in Florida where he didn't have to pay rent? I don't understand. Yeah. Why are you paying rent on vacation?
It is a lot better to go on vacation without... Family. I'm not like without family, but
if you got like a, if you got like a cool nuts. Brother, you could bring them along. But like,
but parents, you do like a more touristy, chill.
That shit's cold.
Who decided to get Bud Light Lime? This shit is fucking trash.
I'm a fucking idiot.
I haven't had
idea was that?
I haven't had Bud Light Lime in like ages.
We had the idea we were bringing bitches home, so give them something to drink.
Yo, you gotta listen. You gotta tone out the, you know, I wasn't trying to get anything. I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, he doesn't like to get in. He doesn't want you to indict him, as he likes to say.
Even though I have no reason to be indicted right now, but that could my brain is
shish kebab.
It could cause future problems because certain people may listen to it, and if they listen to it, they may not like the
thing. If it's like hypothetically you got some future girlfriend and she listens to some shit you did like 6 months ago, who gives a fuck?
Are you saying it's gonna be 6 months before I have a girlfriend again?
I'm saying who cares if your future girlfriend, like, she sucked a dick 6 months ago. Who gives a fuck?
That's one dick too many, sir.
She said, that's one podcast too many.
I guess you're right. Yeah. Oh, we're going to have an episode all about Tinder.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, mostly Tinder, because that shit...
I mean, I could talk about Tinder all day, son.
Yo.
You're on it all day, son.
Yo. Hey, what did I tell you about?
He said that's you how you're gonna meet your future girlfriend, bro. It's okay.
I love it, dude.
It's okay. You saying it's gonna be 6 months till I get a girlfriend?
Yo, so this is the idea we had for our Tinder episode. Not only were we gonna talk about like our experiences, like going on dates and whatnot,
dating in general,
and success and lack of success, and how many dates have been bailed on, like. We wanted to do a segment where we look through our matches with, like, all the really, like, ugly, nasty, fat...
Bro.
...girls that you accidentally swiped.
I feel like we're about to get into this
I showed him, bro.
I was mad. I was like, yo, this Tinder shit sucks. I thought Tinder was about to be popping. And my coworker was like, first thing you gotta do is just shotgun. I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? He's just like, just keep on fucking swiping, bro. Don't even clear... And then you clear it out later. And that shit leads to some monstrosities, bro. Like... that shit leads to some shit where you're like, what the fuck?
He was going through something...
Get yourself together, son. Compose yourself.
He was going...
What the fuck?
You're drooling.
He literally just rolled out. And he's drooling right now because he's laughing so hard. He's gonna hyperventilate. This better be as funny as you're making it seem. You gonna have a heart attack?
I'm at work. Oh, well, I got ahead of myself. Hold on.
He looks like he's gonna cry. He legit looks sad now.
Oh my god!
We can't have 3 minutes of just laughter.
I can't stop.
Just the thought of it.
I can't stop.
Just the thought of it.
I need an MRI. I need an MRI. I got soft tissue damage. Jesus. There's no way I don't have soft tissue damage.
Bro, now it's hurting me right now.
I feel like I did ab work.
7 minute abs?
Yo, how come it sounds like we're talking into a hallway now? Okay, I don't know.
Oh yeah, we should probably apologize in advance. It's panned weird. It's probably gonna sound weird. We don't quite have this new program figured out yet.
We'll get it.
We'll work it out. But for now, whatever. It's our recorded voices. If that's all you need. But we're not getting much of his voice. He does the fucking.
So
he was going. I was at work. And,
he was going through some things with his TOB. For people that don't know what a TOB is, it's that one bitch.
Yeah.
That just infuriates you.
We gotta copyright that shit.
And he was Tindering real hard, and he was doing his shotgun method, where he just did. He got whatever he got. This nigga texts me.
I don't ever see that this hard.
This nigga texts me. And sends me this shit. He said, I'm gonna kill myself. My life is over.
This is what my life has come to. It's funnier if you see the face. You gotta see this bitch's face.
Oh my god.
She looks like she
I didn't
not
see
even...
the teeth the first time you
showed
me.
Oh, bro, the teeth. She looks like she's not even trying to be sexy. Shut the fuck up. I must have caught him off. Didn't you call me because you were laughing so hard?
Bro, I was at work. I had to fucking go to the back. Almost shit myself.
He texted me back. I could tell. Oh, God. I could tell just. I sent you all those pictures?
No, this is when I found her.
When you found her? Oh, bro, how hard did you laugh when you found her?
Oh, my God.
Like, bro, she looked like she ain't even trying. That's what he found.
That bitch look like she
you
eat
gotta,
me.
You gotta have it of fighting bitches that look like they wanna eat you, bro.
This bitch has french fries on her face with ketchup.
But she looks like she's
single taken hungriest checked.
She looks like she'd at least be funny.
Oh man.
You should hit her up.
Obviously that's a joke.
Oh, exactly. It's gotta be.
But yeah, so, bro, she used to be a man. Or a horse, I haven't figured it out yet.
So, it goes ear to ear, literally.
She's transhuman, she used to be a horse.
So, I apologize.
Bro, I don't know if I've ever seen you laugh this
hard. I've never laughed that hard in my life.
Just thinking back to that memory, how hard did you laugh when it happened?
Bro,
it was
just
like that?
I had, and Angel was on the microphone, like, calling me. I couldn't respond. I just had to fucking just cool off.
My face hurts now.
Mine too.
My abs hurt. Yeah, I was slapping. See, that's what I've been missing in my life.
Laughter?
These laughs.
Yeah?
Like, Corey's funny. We laugh.
I'm not funny enough.
You know, but like, there's certain things... It wasn't even that it's funny. It's just the circumstances happened.
Yeah, it's just the way. Yeah, that. I think you called me, or you might have texted me right after. But
I called you.
Is that what it was? And you were just like, bro. Ah! You were just dying laughing. I was like, yo, I didn't think it was going to be that funny.
Oh, man. That's the hardest I've laughed since, like, Miguel's been out of the team.
Yeah, I believe it. I believe it.
Me and Miguel.
That's
like the combination of our laughs were just unlike
his was fucking ridiculous.
Anything else?
We gotta get Scott on the podcast one day. We gotta turn the levels down.
Way down.
Yeah. But yeah, no, that was definitely a low point for me. When I matched with that, I was just like, this is what my life has become.
So don't worry, guys. We're going to give you a full Tinder episode. This is...
I think we just got the best part of that episode.
Yo, I know.
You just died for 3 minutes straight.
I'll do it again.
What is that face? I wish we could show them somehow. It's just this is why we should and fucking... Oh.
The Tinder episode is going to be a video podcast.
You know what? When I post the track for the artwork instead of the podcast, I should put a face.
Yes, you should. That's so fucked up. Because our logo is...
Oh, that's right.
It's using the podcast, they can see. I should put her face on it.
They won't know until like, 30 minutes?
Yeah. But you'll be like, why the fuck? There's a reason.
That shit is fucked up.
But it's funny.
Yeah, but like, here's the thing. I don't understand how certain women think... I mean, the same thing. I think I'm okay looking.
I know what you're saying.
But I get no matches, but...
But it's like, yo,
There's a certain level
of... Just take a decent pic. Don't fucking look... Don't put your teeth like that when you take a picture when you're trying to get dudes to like you. Like there's just... It don't matter really how good or how bad you look. Just take a decent picture.
She looked transhuman, too.
She did.
That and a rat. Like, she had this...
She used to be a sewer rat.
She's Stuart Little.
She used to be Master Splinter.
Stuart Little?
Yeah, Stuart Little.
Stuart Little reference. Good job, sir.
No, I'm telling you, the people that actually listen to our podcast... however few there are, they must think we're fucking assholes.
Cause we are.
But like, we're the nicest people you could ever meet.
We're not. See, that's the
we're
thing.
Super reliable.
We just be making jokes.
Yeah,
it's just jokes. But at the same time, like sometimes when you keep it all the way real with people, they think you're an asshole. And yo, if you're gonna get on Tinder and take a picture of yourself, regardless of how ugly you are, just don't take a stupid ass picture too. Yeah, like don't make it worse for yourself.
I hate when the girls do the same face in every goddamn picture. Bro. The squinted eye, like squished forehead.
The Justin Bieber, they do that fucking... Nobody can see it, but yeah, everybody knows what you're talking about.
Quiet.
Everybody knows what the fuck you're talking about. It's dumb.
Quick chime in on Tinder real quick, and then we gotta close the Tinder segment.
Yeah, before we do a whole episode.
Me?
Yeah.
What do you want me to say?
Tell me what's your experience.
Have you had some experience with Tinder?
Like one positive and all the rest lame.
Who is the positive?
The girl in Pueblo.
I've been drinking.
Literally,
I've been drinking.
Out of Tinder, all I've gotten is... a couple bad dates and one chick that turned out to be a good friend. That's it.
I've gotten one continuous hookup and the rest absolutely nothing.
I haven't even gotten a hookup.
I can either confirm or deny if I've gotten a hookup. Actually, I will on the actual episode. It's a juicy story.
Yeah,
it's about a thought, but whatever.
A thought?
Is it who I know?
Is it your T.O.B. also? She's a thought and a T.O.B.?
No, it's Audrey. Fuck that bitch.
Oh, shit. Name dropping.
Yeah, I name drop. Her name's Audrey Hope Rose.
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
I dropped the fucking government.
You went too far. You went a
fucking
little too far
bitch.
On that shit. Damn. Somebody's bitter.
She stood me up on Valentine's Day, nigga.
That is fucked up. That's
hey, you still have hard feelings about
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
That's fucked up,
I think
bro.
About her more than T.O.B.
Well, it's recent.
It's,
but, yeah.
but it's not. No, it's not. It hasn't been that recent. We're talking about Valentine's Day, nigga. That was a long time ago.
He's salty, though. He's still salty, right? I don't blame you, though. You know why you're salty and bitter? Because you ain't had no closure.
Yeah. There wasn't no
even a simple,
closure. Like,
even a simple, hey, look, we can't do this anymore.
Didn't you guys
cool.
talk a little bit after the fact?
Yo, bro. It was,
like, nothing came of it?
No, it's bullshit. It's bullshit. And the last message, I ain't even going to talk about it. Fuck that bitch.
Save that for
We'll save
time.
It for that episode.
Save that
yeah.
for
that episode's going to be interesting.
I'm fresh out of fucks.
Yeah, I'm fresh out of fucks, too, bro.
Are you fresh out of fucks?
I'm in South Beach, yeah.
That's a good answer. Good answer.
So, back to you, Bob. So you're experiencing Florida, which we were talking about that, and somehow you've gotten to Tinder and
bitches.
An amazing laugh. Probably top 10 laughs of all time in the history of mankind. It was up there.
You're welcome.
So
supplied.
So what was your tell me about your time here?
Thanks, Jim. Well,
got Jim. See, the key is he gives you a white name, you gotta give him a black name.
Yeah, I gotta Jim? I gotta
Jim's not black enough.
I gotta Tyrone.
That's
right. Don't give him ideas.
Darius.
I wanna hear what comes out.
Thanks, Darius.
Darius. No, he gave you that one. You gotta come up with your own. Come on.
I'm racist enough.
We'll go with Darius.
I got nothing, actually. I'm stumped right now.
Damn. You can't think of like Leroy or fucking...
Just name a famous black person and move on.
Tyreek.
Tyreek.
Anything with Dante, Ty in front
Dante.
Of it, just Dante.
Dontarius. Day-Day.
Yeah, my brain's going fried right now.
All right, let's move on. So anyways. South Florida. When we were out... in downtown Fort Lauderdale. I've seen downtown Fort Lauderdale a million times in my life. And quite frankly, I don't really like it. But your face, you were like a kid in a candy store. It was amazing. You were looking at it through a different set of eyes.
That was very different from what I'm used to.
He had no neck.
Oh, none.
Has your neck recovered?
He couldn't.
I'm a little sore.
You could see that you couldn't believe how many fine chicks that were out there.
In Colorado, what were you saying? There's one attractive...
one really, really attractive chick per night, at most, if not...
really?
Throughout multiple places.
Yeah.
Bro, if you go downtown, you see five as soon as you pull up.
And that night, I swear, every woman that was in there was attractive. Every single one.
Pretty much.
It's pretty close to that. The ratio is pretty good.
I didn't understand. I was like, what is with this?
I think what it is, in Colorado, it's not superficial. Out here, it's superficial. So, all the ugly bitches... excuse me, I call you bitches because I don't know your name.
There you go. So, Cat Williams said it best.
Exactly. Sorry if I'm stealing his jokes.
No, it's good.
But,
so it's not as superficial out there.
It's not as superficial out there.
So what does that mean? Like, chicks be walking around in, like, sweatpants and shit?
Over here...
hair tied, chilling with no makeup
on? Over here
is
like...
some, yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah?
Yeah, over here, they don't care. It's not about, like... who looks the best, really.
Bro, these chicks down here, they be getting fucking cheeks hanging out and
shit. Well, one thing, it's cold three-fourths of the year.
That's a good point, too.
You gotta wear jackets and beanies and
shit. So they can't look
that
hot.
Yeah, exactly.
Remember that fucking bitch Audrey I was talking about? That bitch couldn't dress.
Because she's used to the cold.
Couldn't dress. No, she had no fashion sense. Part of our date for Valentine's Day was supposed to be... me taking her to Macy's to buy some clothes.
That sounded like a nice...
yeah, but go back. Sorry, I apologize.
Kind of stealing my moment.
Don't clap again. I think you might have spiked.
All right, my bad. Go ahead.
All right, my bad. Back to you, buddy.
Where are we at?
Your experience.
Kid in a candy store.
Kid in a candy store.
Yeah, that was fun.
A man of few words.
But many talents.
But no, it was cool. Like, because, like I said, this has been my whole life. It's interesting to see the perspective of somebody that's, like, not been around it. And your face...
when you come to Colorado, I'll see the opposite.
Yo, my perspective is going to be fucking just me chilly as fuck. That's
going
to be
but
my
you're going during the summer. You'll be all right. It still gets pretty cold at night, though.
Yeah. That's true. That's how I want to start. If I would have come down in the dead of winter, bro, I would have been no fun, I promise you.
But this motherfucker...
we bar hop when it's snowing.
Yeah. This motherfucker will go out when it's snowing because he doesn't want a coat check. He'll go out in like a G-string and a fucking tank top.
Go in a banana hammock.
Doesn't matter. Outside, once you get inside, you'll be fine.
Nah, he's got a good point. But it's just to walk from the car to the club and then you're good.
And except for when there's a line.
Oh, that's shitty.
So you struggle for 5-10 minutes, then you're in.
Yo, there was one time
point.
That it was unbearably cold. We're talking like 2-3 degrees.
Oh, dog, I can't even imagine.
You can even comprehend that cold?
I literally can't. The last time, like, I went to New York when I was, like, 12.
Oh, it can get cold.
And it snowed, but I don't think it was 2 degrees. It was cold. I went to Niagara Falls. It was cold as fuck. But I don't know if it was that cold.
Well, the degrees really don't matter. Anything after 30 degrees is just fucking cold.
Yeah.
Well, you add wind chill.
That's what changed.
Because, like, I can't really tell the difference between 30 degrees... and 2 degrees.
I'm sure, yeah.
Unless there's wind. Like, it just feels like cold. And what's cool about Colorado is you can, like, wear a tank top in, like, 30, 40 degree weather because as long as the sun is out, it's not windy, because the sun is so much closer. Like, since you're so high up, you're 6,000 feet in the air, and like you're just suspended in the air, you know. No,
I was refraining from commenting on that just to not hurt your feelings.
Yeah, no. So you're 6,000.
Yeah, I know. I knew it was gonna be a problem.
The elevation is 6,000 feet, and I keep burping on the podcast. It's very professional. So it's just nice. The sun is baking the shit out of you.
Sounds pretty.
You don't sweat.
But yeah, that sounds interesting.
No humidity at all.
Dude, I can't even imagine life without humidity.
None.
I literally can't imagine it.
It's a depreciation of
it
humidity.
Might be amazing for me. It's just I don't feel wet.
Keep chapstick on you at all times.
Oh yeah. I feel
their
wet.
Lips literally.
Oh, I bet. I feel wet all the time, dude.
I know.
My entire life, I just feel wet, and I'm used to it.
I can't imagine living like that all the time.
There's no swamp ass.
No way. Uh-uh. Bro, here, it's like legit.
You walk outside, you have swamp
ass. It's legit like 80 degrees most of the year.
Yeah.
Like most of the year. It's in the 80s.
Yeah. Like 90% of the year.
Yeah.
It's
legit, son. And during the summer, it's in like the 90s.
Even will push and hit 100.
The most I've ever seen, I was like a kid. I think it was like 102. I haven't seen it since.
Dog, I've seen like 106.
Bro. I think the most I've seen is 102, and I was like a kid.
You get over 100 sometime in Colorado. It's just dry. It's not. It's
oh
not
yeah,
humidity
that's
also.
Still probably pretty shitty though.
It's still hot. Yeah.
Yeah, it's still different. But yeah. So I'm coming in like the middle end of May, so shouldn't be too bad. But I'm
also
excited
not
to check it out.
Not too far from now.
No, I'm coming the 20th to the 23rd. That's good, right?
Good. I didn't fully go through that yet, but yeah, it's gonna be fine.
All right. Well, we good then.
Yeah, I got you. Don't worry.
But yeah. Yeah, we haven't fully. Yeah. I've been trying to do it for a grip, but just shit. I haven't been able to take the time off of work. Fucking having a job, but whatever.
Yeah.
I finally decided that I'm not gonna ask for the time off. I'm just gonna say these are the days and take it off.
See ya.
Yeah. Exactly. So it should be interesting. I haven't been out of the state in a long fucking time.
That's what I did to be here. So
yeah.
I'm gonna be gone. So.
Exactly. How long has it been since you've been out of Colorado? When was the last time?
That's a good question. When was the last time I was out of Colorado?
Any day now.
Talking like upwards of 5 years?
Not that long.
No.
Wow, what was the last thing I did? Might have been driving to... Oh, it was a year and a half ago. I drove to Kansas.
Oh yeah,
from Colorado. But my college, we went to the national championships for football.
Okay.
So drove to watch that.
Cool.
But that's Kansas. So. Nothing special
not
about that.
Yeah, not like it's not downtown Fort Lauderdale.
No. Or South Beach. No.
Yeah.
It doesn't compare.
So yeah, what's your highlight? What's your favorite thing?
Here. There's a lot of them. I mean,
come on, mention
all,
some things.
It's all positive, but I mean, one big one was staying at a hotel in Pompano, walking out back, and there being the beach just right there.
Bro.
And this going in the water.
Mm-hmm. It's a dream. You know, I'm sorry I didn't invite you. I thought you were...
Yeah, no,
I thought you were busy.
I was mad.
Why?
No, I wasn't mad. Of course
even
not.
Just when I just flown in, got an Uber, went to your hotel you were at the time, and walking up to your floor and then looking and seeing the sunrise coming over the Atlantic. That was pretty dope.
It's fucking gangster.
Going out down here is
see that's
way
like
way different.
I have a different perspective on it after seeing it from your perspective. Because bro, I've lived 5 minutes from the beach for like 5 years. And I've gone like 5 times.
To the
like,
beach?
Yeah. Like I almost never go to the fucking beach.
I mean
and I live
when,
right by it.
Yeah, when you live and you have your life going, it's different than vacationing.
It's, yeah, it is, but it's still like the last like
then what
month
do you do on the weekends.
The last like month or two, I work a lot on the weekends.
Oh, okay.
The last like month or two
days off. I mean,
yeah, the last like month or two, I've gone more frequently, and I'll just lay out, and I'm just like, yo, this is super dope.
The
like,
beach is amazing.
It's just super dope.
Listen, I love the mountains to death,
But okay, beach, you can walk up to it, sit down, didn't cost you any money. You go to the mountains in Colorado, you gotta buy a lift ticket, you gotta buy ski jacket, ski pants, you gotta boots, pay an administrative skis, bindings.
Well, if you go hiking, you're...
you gotta spend $1,000 easy just
you gotta, to ski. All you gotta spend money on here is flip-flops and swim trunks.
And a towel.
And a towel.
Yeah, but you can also enjoy the mountains from afar.
Yeah, I mean, that's well, true. Look at them, but there are free things to do in the mountains.
So. Yeah, so.
Yeah.
But, skiing is expensive.
Oh, I bet.
But, like, no. Like, the ocean is just... there's nothing like the ocean.
Yeah, it's there's something about being cleansed in the waters of Lake Minnetonka.
For me, I'm used to California. That's where I've gone most of my life.
Yeah.
Here, the water's not...
I want to visit California,
fucking freezing. Like California water. Yeah. And here it's clear water. California it's freezing and murky as shit. You can't see.
So that's how you get
2 inches into the water. Huh?
That's how you get bit by the sharks.
I think there's way more sharks out here than in California.
Probably.
For real?
I think so.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any sharks in California. At least Southern Cal. I don't know about Northern.
Sworn surfers be getting eaten.
We went on, I don't know.
Don't quote me.
We went on an impromptu jet ski run today. And this motherfucker the whole time was on dorsal fin patrol.
Oh, yeah. I was just like, yo, if you see it.
Were you nervous?
He was like, he was joking, but like, you could sense the tone.
No, serious. I wasn't like scared.
No. But concerned.
But I had situational awareness.
Not going to lie, that thought didn't even cross my mind for a second.
Not even once for me either.
I was just going.
I was like, I was not worried about
I'm talking animal. About when we were in the bay, really, like the little area. That's,
I know. I was just full throttle, not even worried.
If I saw one dorsal fin,
he said he was gonna clear it.
I'm gonna clear it. I was gonna be out of there.
I wasn't.
You would have never seen me again. I don't even care if it was a manatee. It didn't even have to be a dorsal fin. If I saw anything gray or brown, moving underwater,
any type of animal, anything that wasn't human in the water, I was gone.
I was clearing it. And maybe if it was a human, I would have cleared it too. They could have been drowning. Clear it.
When you guys switched and one hop off, or you guys just
no,
switched?
Hell no, I wasn't.
That was the. I was like, yo, I'll hop off. But he was like, fuck. He was like, I'm not hopping off. And I was like, all right, we'll make this.
What do you think?
We made it happen.
In the water, the jaws
just
gonna come.
Yeah, just instantly gone.
Instantly, just you're
like. I told him, I was like, what if you know those when like you see a great white shark just fly out of the water? I was like, what if that happened? He's just like, I would have just ducked. It's just...
I would have shit myself.
I definitely would have shit myself.
I would have cleared it.
I definitely would have shit instantly. Even if I saw that shit way in the distance. I'm done. I'm gone.
Yo, bro, how slow you were going on the jet ski, bro, we would have been dead. This dude was going 2.5 miles per hour.
Them waves were crazy. Hey, man, I got up to like 17.
Yeah. I got
when
to,
I was full, I was getting... some of the errors were scaring me.
You were fucking flying. But what's the fastest you went?
I think like 50 something. 55, 57.
You hit 57, it only can go to 50.
Oh, that's okay. How good it was going.
47 then.
Yeah.
What'd you get to, like 30?
30 was the highest. And
for
I
real?
Immediately slowed
did
the
fuck. Did
you
not even go full?
Bro,
I don't know how you were doing. I don't know. We couldn't go full retail.
Because I just did it.
I don't know how
I'm
you were
telling
doing
you there's something wrong with it. With
I think our
that
desk
too,
was
but also I
up.
Wouldn't have been that careless with
I'll say,
with
yeah,
someone
you were by
else
yourself
with me.
Too, yeah.
I said to him, I was like, thank God I wasn't on it with Corey. I would have been crying.
I would have been throwing you off
when he got when he said
I would have gone, and you'd have been gone.
When we,
I told him.
When we switched, and he sat behind me.
I said, "There's no scenario that I fall off this without you falling off." I
no,
locked my fingers
no
into
way,
his jacket.
There's no way I fall off by myself.
So, it's not happening.
If I go, you going with me? I was like, "All right."
I would have tried to throw on you. I would
have
tried
for real.
Of course.
Probably for fun.
That's not
funsies.
Fun.
The first time I ever got on a jet ski was with my girlfriend at the time. 2 seconds in, boop, I was gone.
She threw you on purpose?
Yeah.
How horrible. I see why she's an ex.
I'm on a long
you're going to be an ex-friend.
For real. They cut you off real quick.
I'm never getting on a jet ski with this
one. Yeah, I would have tossed you off and I would have gone.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Bro, I would have cried.
What if
I would legit
cry.
Saw
a dorsal fin immediately.
Oh my god. It would have just popped up everywhere. It was like all pointed at me.
It started circling.
Like a fucking cartoon.
I wouldn't have left you, bro. I just would have thrown you and I would have sat right there and waited for you.
There's really, that's kind of funny.
I literally would have cried.
It's fun.
The water's dark. You can't see.
It's paranoid, dude.
Yeah, paranoid because I've seen every black movie.
He said, I've seen Deep Blue Sea. I know what they do to us.
Talking about that the other day.
A fucking shark ate him.
Real quick, fast.
I mean, I got thrown in a reservoir. There weren't sharks there.
Yeah. LL Cool J made it, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, so good. You could have been him. You're light anyway.
You know what?
You'd have made it.
Maybe.
You'd have been LL Cool J.
As long as Greg was in the water, I was fine.
Exactly.
He did once.
It don't matter about... The white bitches are all dying, and there weren't any with us, so we're good.
Well, you were with me, so...
Fuck you. I would have made it.
So, since you were talking about your highlights of this trip, is there any other particular moment that you want to talk about or express?
Express.
Any other moments that were just...
That were fun?
Really good?
Day one was pretty good.
It was. I liked it.
Oh, going downtown? Going to Fort Lauderdale?
The beach, yeah.
The beach was dope. Went to the beach, met some ladies.
That was a good night. A good day.
It was, and I met up with him later, yeah.
He got married.
Yeah, exactly.
What is it called when you get married on... Eloped.
Yeah, eloped, yeah, eloped.
He eloped?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
She stopped texting me already, so it looks looking good.
That girl's an alcoholic.
Yo.
Why do you think she went extra buck.
She had the
alcoholic face.
She had less control. Like, her friends seemed like more in control, and she was just kind of like, woo!
Really?
Just whatever!
Well, maybe I was on that level, too.
I think that whole day I was on that level. That's why you guys clicked. You both had zero inhibitions.
They both gave zero fucks.
Definitely. You both were fresh out.
Fresh out, yeah.
You checked your drawers.
Trying to make out in the ocean, freaking salt water on our faces. It was a shit show.
I like that term. A shit show?
I like shit show.
It was a shit show. But I don't use that
nearly enough.
It was an enjoyable shit show.
I got a shit show to talk about.
Oh, yeah?
For you.
For me.
But we're going to get into that later. It's an experience in Colorado in a little restaurant called King Chef's. Actually, I'll get into it right now.
Oh, man. So, you're putting me on blast then?
Yeah, I'm putting you on blast.
Oh, man.
So,
there's a few of them.
So we all go out together and we're fucking pounding drinks left and right.
For me, it's right all Patron
left,
shots.
Right and left. Patron
oh,
shot.
Nice.
Patron.
All
yeah,
Patron.
He chased his Patron with Patron.
He chased it with Patron.
A little bit of
nice.
Lime.
With a little bit of lime.
Nice.
Patron.
He said lime.
Lime.
Lime in the coconut. Mix it all around.
Yeah.
So we finished getting fucked up. And this dude says, let's go to King Chef. It's a burrito place. Burrito breakfast place.
Open till
sounds
like
dope.
4 or 5, 4 o'clock
in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Just down the block from all the bars downtown in Colorado Springs.
So that's where all the drunk people go to eat.
Exactly.
Nice.
So we're all getting our food. He just got his food. I'm in line.
I didn't get anything. I was gonna share a cold.
Yeah, exactly. So
I didn't even get in line.
His boy got his food. He got his food. Everything was kosher.
Gucci.
Everything was Gucci, mine, and then I'm in line, and then a lady's telling me a story about this place, that, oh yeah, the food's excellent, you should get this, it's amazing, blah, 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 the only thing you gotta worry about is people throwing up in their own food, and then our coworker taps me on the shoulder literally after she said that, I didn't even put my order in, finish putting my order in, he's like, dude, Corey's throwing up on his food, I'm like...
Just like that?
Yeah, just like that. That dude, we call him Rocket Power. That guy.
Colorado.
Yo, the first time I introduced him to Greg, he's talking about surfing. I mean, not surfing, snowboarding. He's like, dude, you don't want to hit death cookies.
What the fuck is a death cookie?
What? Andrew said that?
Yeah, death cookies.
What the hell is that?
It's like a piece of a rock or ice that you hit with your snowboard.
Oh, I can see that.
And they call them death cookies.
So he's like the mountain version of like the surfer dudes down here.
Yeah.
Precisely. Yeah.
That dude is a fucking habitual liar, though. I know he lies.
That's a different story. Don't get sidetracked.
But, so then...
Death cookies.
So then Jared turns around and sees...
That he's puking. into a cup. At least he tried to save it.
I was gonna say.
And he gets kicked out of the place. They have like a bouncer inside the fucking restaurant.
Like a few of them.
Yeah.
For dumbasses like me.
I was gonna say, they probably should,
yeah. Yeah, but he's grabbing him by his neck and shit and then throws out.
They're nice to me.
Unnecessarily.
Colton, who they were nice to.
Oh, yeah. They threw out his friend because they called. Colton called them a pussy for like pulling him and.
Yeah.
Throwing
for
him
me?
Out. Yeah. And so they throw him out.
Okay.
Then they try to charge him a fuck nigga fee. Tell me how they have
a puking fee.
They have a puking fee. $25 puking fee.
What?
And they're trying to get him to pay it. I was like, there's
fuck that.
In no scenario I would never pay that shit. That's you decided to have your business hours.
Exactly.
For
you know you're getting
you know,
exactly.
Yeah.
You know your clientele.
These are the people that are making you money.
Exactly. You
fuck
ain't getting no, ain't charging me no fuck
no
that's exactly what that is.
And then he threw up in my car.
Nice.
I did?
Oh, outside.
Your new car?
Outside, yeah. Outside the window, inside the door,
got
a little
track
bit.
Record of outside window puking.
Oh, New Year's, this guy threw up in an Uber.
out
the window.
Better an Uber than your actual car, I mean.
If it was anyone else that, like, if it was Rocket Power that threw up in my car, I would beat his ass. I would have beat his ass. That's how you know I love you, Corey. Otherwise, I would have.
Thank goodness.
I would have had to beat your ass for that. But anyways, so yeah, back to you, Bob. Highlights, bro. What else? What else? You got any other stories?
I feel like you're pushing for something. Are you trying to get that good story?
Yeah, I'm trying to get a good story.
You trying to get the scoop?
I always talked about the one.
Are you trying to get the scoop?
What else are you looking for?
Last night?
What is this? It's like...
What happened last night?
Dude, do you not remember where I took you?
Bro, do you not remember what happened last night that I didn't get invited to?
Bro, there's so much shit that's happened in a freaking few days. I can't keep it all straight.
That's Hurricane Jared, bro. That's how it happens.
Last night, yes. We saw Sansa.
Sansa Stark.
And
Sansa?
India. And what, Red Dress?
I don't like Sansa. I don't like that name.
Sansa is a character from
Game of Thrones.
Yo. I mean, we went to Scarlet, so I'll say it because he.
I'll say it. Fuck.
Can't,
I was getting
like
there.
Like anybody
shit.
Cares. All right,
just get in there. Sorry,
man,
get in there. Get
anxious.
In there.
Get in there like swimwear.
You already said it. Continue.
No.
We went
but
to Scarlet's.
What's Scarlet's?
The strip club. Apparently, it was.
Apparently.
And how does that compare to Colorado strip clubs?
Not
bro,
even,
are they balls there or what?
Not even. Oh my.
Are they balls?
They're balls.
Are they please explain TNT's.
Balls in what way?
TNT. we went there
just
on
by
like
the way
a
he laughed,
on like
be good.
On like a Wednesday night. We went there. There was five girls dancing.
What the fuck?
One looked like she was on LSD
in slow motion up on stage. Just
what?
None of them were fit. Except actually, one of them was fit.
They weren't all bad.
Yeah.
There's five of them. So
this,
what?
Yeah.
Two out of three were okay.
So it was mostly.
I mean,
down.
Two out of five were okay.
There was five of them. Two out of three were okay. The other two were missing.
It's okay.
So, but yeah.
The Scarlet's is that was.
He caught it on. He caught it on a slow day. They didn't even open up. They only had a third of it opened.
But we went. It was all open, wasn't it?
All the fucking open. All the fucking.
All the fuck.
What other parts could be open?
They had the upstairs. There's a whole another half to that building, and then, like, when you walk in and you head to where you get your lap dance, there's another area to the right that wasn't open either. It was in curtains.
That's a big ass fucking place.
It's,
oh really?
Yeah.
Yeah, and there was like 25 to 30 girls there.
Yeah.
On a good night, like probably like 80.
Yeah. When easy. we went, bro, it was packed full
packed.
Of chicks.
Dude,
packed.
I can't even fathom that.
Packed with chicks.
How many dances did you get yesterday?
Oh, two.
I had four.
Why not? You're at Scarlet's, bro.
And then I pulled out like $200 in ones, and he threw in $60 in ones, and we were just throwing ones everywhere. It was good.
Nice.
I want to have an episode dedicated to strip clubs.
We could have a strip club episode. Next time you go to Scarlet's.
He'll be
send
there.
Send a motherfucking invite.
And Nathan was mad too that I didn't hit him up. He's like, dog.
Right? We could all.
He drove past Scarlett's on the way home.
Damn, bro. We could all got together
man,
for that.
Just one himself or just you and me, I guess.
My. I had the Michael Jackson.
You gotta start taking a breath and thinking about what you're gonna say.
Jamal. What does that do to James Brown? Just hat. Zap. Pop. Pop. Pop.
What the fuck is he saying?
What the fuck? I don't know, but yeah.
Sounds good.
Definitely next time you invite him.
Seduce me though. We were all set for this one girl to come back.
Fine is all fun.
Come back and dance for me, and then this Indian girl that talked to me earlier just went and sat in my lap, and she had me.
I knew it.
No, so you should have been mad, but you were like, I didn't teach him proper
stripper defense.
I could if I wanted to.
You don't build that up in Colorado.
Yo.
She knew what she was doing.
I'm the type of dude that when I see what I like, I'll pick my dance. Like, that's what I do.
I like what I like.
And I immediately linked eyes with one chick, and I knew that was the one that was going to get my money tonight.
Red dress?
Red dress.
And yeah, she was cute.
So I already told her that she was the one. Like, I went up to her while she was doing her dance on the side. I was like, yo, you the one? I started throwing some ones to her. But then I saw the one that I probably should have gave all my money to. Sansa.
Oh.
Yo, let me...
6'1".
She's 6'1", but god damn it.
Snoo snoo. Ass.
And
you need a snoo snoo?
And yo, son, she had a English accent. Like,
oh bro. Yeah. I like where this is going.
I'm lucky that I did not hear that, because then she would have got all my money too.
Yeah,
did either you guys get a dance from her?
Yeah. Hold on, we'll get there. So, okay. So the one first...
We call who has quickly become the two.
The two. Yeah. I go into...
The backup.
I go into to get a dance from her. And then we're like, you know, just dancing. Doing the damn thing.
Doing the damn thing.
She's doing good. I love that you can actually touch the strippers here, where you can't touch them in Colorado. It's so trash. And you can't even drink at the strip clubs.
You know, that side note. I heard that it was like... I can't remember who. It was like a stand-up bit, and they were talking about strip clubs, and they were like, you can't even touch the strippers. And I'm like, what strip clubs you go to?
Where you go?
Because the strip clubs I go to, you could touch them. But yeah, that's weird. I didn't know that.
So yeah, you can't... Damn, you're pounding those beers, bro. That's your fourth
I'm
one.
On vacation.
Exactly. No, I enjoy it.
He says that all... That's what he always says when he's down. I'm on vacation.
So, pound...
And I'm on no altitude, so I gotta try a lot harder.
So then this girl hits me with this trick right before the song's about to end. Like, this gangster-ass trick. She, like, it's hard to explain. She's like, put your feet flat down. I was like, all
right. And this is the one, right?
And, yeah, no, this is the one. Not the tall. I'm like, okay. And she puts her hands on my knees, and it flips over and rolls, and then her ass is in my face. Like, so
she,
like...
So she moved forward.
Yeah.
I've seen that move. Yeah, I've seen that move.
Yeah. Roll.
Nice.
India slip. Played some tricks on me, too.
Nice.
And then she's like, upside down, and she's like, you want another dance? I'm like...
I kind of gotta.
You damn right, dude.
If you stay where you are, hell yeah, I want another dance.
And then,
That's some fucking devious shit
then,
right there.
And then she's...
Right at the end of the song, hits dance, you with that.
That's what Indian did to me, too.
She's like, that's my second best trick.
And you're
knows how to work.
Yeah, she was working me, and then she stood me up, and then started like twerking on my genitals.
You want my genitals?
Yes,
my genitals.
My genitals. I gotta keep it friendly. Keep it kosher.
Talking about strippers having their asses in your face.
that friendly went out the window a while ago.
Yeah.
So then, I'm done with that dance, and Corey's about to get his dance, so we're just waiting, and then that Indian chick gets on his lap. It's totally... I knew he was done. The way she got on his lap is how I knew it was over. She got on his lap in the front and had her neck on his neck.
Yeah.
And
her neck was on my neck.
Yeah, because she was like whispering in your ear. Oh, she's like... Yeah. Face all up against,
yeah, that's,
and then like breathing on your ear and
they
shit.
Gotcha.
I was like, he's done.
But he's
then
done.
I saw the tall chick, and I immediately turned my head away because I didn't want to spend no more money. I was like, I spent over $220.
Oh no!
And then she sit down next to me, and I'm like, I know that's her right next to me. And I turn, and I'm like, fuck. And I said it to her just like that. I was like, fuck. Why you had to come over and sit? I spent all the, whole bunch of fucking money, and I didn't want to spend any more, and now I got to go get a dance. Let's go. And I got a dance for
that's
her.
That's awesome.
Dog.
Was it awesome? Out of anger.
It was amazing. Yeah. Her body was just out of this world. Like, and her back lasted forever. It was long as hell, but it was great.
I like that description.
Oh, and she had long hair like to her ass.
Oh,
and really?
Yeah,
just all the way down her long ass back.
Yeah, it was just it was something extraordinary. And then I told her, I was like, if I would have given her all my money
from the get. If
we walk in and I knew what was to come. And then she actually had a conversation with me about TV shows and shit afterwards. She was cool
as fuck.
See, it's not like those Spanish chicks that be at Pure Platinum.
Bro, they sound like they're reading from a script.
Juandas, papi.
They say, Juandas, what's your name? where you from? Like, that's it. And then they just say shit like, you can tell they don't know English because they just say like, you're very nice. They just be like, you're very nice. Very nice. I'm like, I know this bitch don't know English and she just got a script memorized. And literally at one point, it was one time I went over there, I was sitting at the bar, three of them came up and hit me with the same script, the same order. I was like, these bitches just have a script in the back that they're just reading.
Yeah, so
it's definitely less personal. That's cool that you had one that was like, that could you
yeah,
talk
was
with
talking to me too. She TV shows was asking and like what strip clubs we have out in Colorado and shit, and she travels apparently to strip.
So did Sansa. Sansa goes from New
like
York.
Professionals.
Yeah, a lot of strippers, they rotate.
So much fucking
India
money.
Goes to Vegas, D.C. She said now she might try and go to Denver, which is bullshitting me probably.
If she does, she'll be the queen of that place based on what you told me.
Yes.
She'll walk in and the money's going
to
go to her.
I've never been to Denver for one, but
okay.
He has.
It's probably dope in Denver, right?
What do you think? How would she do in Denver? Kill it?
The one that you're talking about? Any of those girls there could kill it in
all
Denver. They do actual tricks in Colorado.
Their tricks are clicking their heels.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
I hate that shit. It's so annoying.
It is.
It's so unsettling.
I don't like it either.
Am I under attack?
Am I under attack? I don't like that shit either.
Well, this is our first episode back.
First one back.
Yeah.
So, get ready for like a delayed schedule. Because we're going to be back, but he comes down once a month. I'm going to go to Colorado. As much as I can.
Damn, how are you going to bring all this? I mean, it's not even that much.
Yeah, no.
You don't have any
but we need.
We'll bring
this.
The shit. But what we need to do, because this is literally like, this is the last moment that we could have possibly done a podcast. What we got to do is when you come down for like a week, we got to record like a couple.
Yeah.
So that we don't have like a huge drought. Yeah. But we got this one.
Space
them out.
Well,
one.
If we do four... Every time I'm here, that's 4 weeks.
That's what we gotta do.
Yeah, that's what we should
do. Bro, when you came down, it was Monday. We were gonna do one, and we both fell asleep. And I was like, the next day, I was like, bro, we got a whole week, son.
And
here we are at the end of that week.
Last day.
Doing one. But, yeah, so we're gonna definitely bring it back. It might be kind of sporadic for right now, but, I'll be out there soon so we could do a couple. And then, like you said, when you come down every month, we'll do a few. And, yeah, man. We got to do that Tinder episode.
Yeah, that'll Tinder,
strip club episode.
So we got some fun shit.
We can combine those two, maybe. You're similar.
I don't know.
It's all about bitches.
With him laughing like that on Tinder might take a while.
That's going to be the whole episode.
I wish we recorded that. That was one of the best laughs. I mean, like, it just...
We got a pretty good rendition of it on here. Like, that was pretty good.
Wasn't that on here?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's talking about the original.
Oh.
That's what you're talking about, right?
No, this one.
That was on here.
We got it.
No, but video.
Oh.
I like this. My face, I thought...
At one point, you literally look like...
You were crying.
Like
I was crying.
It looked like the death of a loved one. Like, your face, like, was mangled like somebody you loved dearly just died. Like...
You know, at one point, I almost threw up.
What?
I almost threw up.
I would have charged you a fee for that.
$25 fuck nigga fee.
$25.
That is the definition. I'm going to say it. That's the definition of a fuck nigga fee right there. is somebody throwing up. You got your place right next to a bar. You stay open till 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning, and you charge motherfuckers $25 to throw up.
It's a hassle definition. Fee. It's called a hassle fee.
That's the fuck out of my face. Hassle.
And like,
fee.
Oh, it's on. It's on the it's on the menu, so you have to.
Fuck that. Did you get out of it?
Of course we didn't pay for that shit. I was like,
I was gonna say, you especially, no, you are not paying. I know you never ain't paying that.
They're
shit.
Trying to get us to pay for it too. I'm like, first off, I wouldn't let you make him pay it.
And there's no way. At this point, I was just standing there, like,
you're outside my car. Room. You're outside my car puking.
More?
That's when you were puking.
Jesus Christ.
He's like embarrassed now.
It's okay. We embarrass him on the podcast. So
it's all good.
This is the Awesome Life Podcast. We're two members of a group called Team Awesome. It's a long-lost, forgotten musical group. We also own a company called Awesome Life Entertainment. Check us out at...
Awesome Life ENT. Twitter, Instagram.
SoundCloud.
That's the important one where this podcast will be. But this podcast is also on iTunes. I got it on iTunes now because I'm official. I got it on Stitcher. And they can go to awesomelifeent.com now. That's the thing.
That's right. We have our own website. I forgot.
Yeah. /podcast. Gets you right to the podcast.
You told me these things.
Yeah, bro. We so official. All we need is a whistle.
We so official. All we need is actual money coming in.
Yeah.
That's the next step.
Yeah. That's when we go from being amateur to professional. That's the definition.
That's true.
Yeah. Once you get paid for services.
That's very true.
Right now we're paying to be serviced.
Definitely paying.
Or to give
to services. Be serviced. You talking about Scarlett's again?
Yo, man.
I paid to be serviced.
I can't wait to talk about that night, like not on the air.
Okay.
I'm not saying those things on the air.
You kind of just did by saying that.
Nah, it's too descriptive.
I got you.
It's too descriptive.
Yeah, Twitter, Instagram, SoundCloud, SoundCloud,
links. Sound sauerkraut.
Links does it all for me. Stay tuned. Like, I'm gonna start recording this bitch in June, so I'm hoping end of June, early July.
New music, more podcasts, less Corey.
Why'd you add a white guy to the group? God, you had to do
it. It's DJ Colorado.
Well, if he can DJ, he can be a part of the group. That's how I got in from rapping.
I'm trying to start, so.
Cool.
Give it.
You don't even have a computer strong enough to use the damn thing. It will not handle that. Handle. It will drop out all the time. Your computer is...
Give me your computer, too.
Fuck you.
You want me to learn or what, bro?
$1,200 program? I mean, $1,200 computer with a $600 program? That's $1,800.
Fine, I won't do it, then.
All right, then, Colorado.
No more DJ Colorado.
It's over before it began.
Too fast.
Yeah, so I just got like real. It's like I'm having a flashback to the first 3 minutes of this bitch.
Yeah, we don't know how to close it out.
It's hard to close out sometimes. But yeah, so it's back. It might be kind of sporadic for right now, but I'm going up there. He'll be back down. We'll make sure we got him on deck so that we don't have to go too long in between episodes. We definitely ain't going a year in between this bitch again because I don't want to go through that first 3 minutes again.
That was bad. We got to get the rust off.
That was real bad.
Gotta just shake it off.
We did a couple practice runs before that, too, and it was still bad.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
Yeah, we definitely, we'll get it together, though. It's going to be good.
All right, well, this is Mr. Phoenix signing out.
It's Lynx.
DJ Colorado.
All right, cool. All right, we'll catch you next time.
Yes, sir.
Bye.
Awesome Life Entertainment. Fuck yeah, awesome, yeah.